everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to start the topic of Herzberg's two-factor theory. So let's get started. Herzberg's motivation theory model or two-factor theory model argues that there are two factors that an organization can adjust to influence motivation in workplace. Ab ye kaun se factors hain? The first one is motivators, which can encourage employees to work harder. Dusre factors hain hygiene factors. These would encourage employees to work harder, but they will cause them to become unmotivated if they are not present. So hygiene factors ka hona zaruri hai aur motivators wo hote hain jo employees ko acha kaam aur mehnat karne ke liye motivate karte hain. So now let's look at Herzberg's two factor theory. So here is the diagrammatical presentation of the same. Poor hygiene factors decrease employees job satisfaction. Motivating factors increase employees job satisfaction. So remember these two important points. ठीक है? Now let's look at the elements falling under the two factors. Motivators के अंडर क्या आएगा? Achievement, recognition, the work itself, responsibility, advancement and growth. Hygiene factors के अंडर है company policies, supervision, relationships, work conditions, remuneration, salary and security. Now let's talk about motivating factors in detail. Okay, the first thing is achievement here. And koi bhi job, if it gives a sense of achievement, it makes the employee feel jo bhi hard work usne kiya, jitna bhi usne mehnat ki, wo safal raha, right? So that feeling is a beautiful feeling that motivates the person to work harder. Recognition ka matlab yehi ho gaya, giving awards or certificates or some sort of recognition to the employee for doing a good job and by the superiors, of course. The work itself, the job must be interesting, varied and provide enough challenges to keep the employee motivated. Next point is responsibility. Employees should own their work. They should hold themselves responsible for the completion of work. So agar success mila, so definitely unhe praise, recognition to milna hi chahiye. Agar nahi bhi mila, so they should realize their mistakes and improve further, right? So they should be completely responsible and in charge of the work given to them. Advancement hai, promotion opportunities deni chahiye, which is a great thing of course. Growth, the job should give employees the opportunity to learn new skills. Personal growth pe bhi dhyan dena zaruri hai. Right? This can happen on the job itself. Nye nye challenges aate to wo khud hi seekhte jaate, unki skills apne aap upgrade hone lagti hai. Or by giving them more formal training. Now let's talk about hygiene factors in detail. The first one here is company's policies, and these should be fair and clear to every employee. Also, it should be equivalent to the competitors. Number two, supervision. Supervision must be fair and appropriate. The employee should be given that amount of autonomy that is required, right? So it should be reasonable. Relationships, there should be no tolerance, absolute no tolerance for bullying or cliques. A healthy, amiable and appropriate relationship should exist between the peers, superiors and subordinates. So it should be friendly, free and fair kind of an environment where an employee should be working. And if this is not present, wo motivate nahin hote hain to work better. Instead, they want to get out of that place as soon as, you know, jaise taise kaam khatam kar liya aur niklo wahan se. Is tarah ka unka behavior ho jata hai. So now let's talk about the next element here, work conditions. Equipment and the working environment should be safe, fit for purpose and hygienic. These are very important things, especially during this pandemic phase. We have realized the importance of hygiene way better than ever. Salary. The pay structure should be fair and reasonable. It should also be competitive with the other organizations, because ye na ho ke kam pay ki wajah se hamare achhe employees kaam chhodkar dusri company join kar le, you know. So that is the reason it should be competitive. Status. The organization should maintain the status of all employees within the organization. Performing meaningful work can provide a sense of status. Ek pride hum le apna kaam karte vak, that I'm proud of the job that I'm doing. Aisa sense of, you know, feeling hona chahiye among the employees, and it's the work of the organization to do the same. To create such kind of an environment where the person is feeling so happy and proud of the work that they are doing. Security, it is important that employees feel that their job is secure and they are not under the constant threat of being laid off. So ye to important hai, kisi bhi kaam mein security ho, so the employee is relieved aur wo calmly apna kaam pe focus kar sakta hai. So before we talk about the application of this model and the criticisms of the model, let's look at the four states an organization or team are categorized into. So the first category is of high hygiene and high motivation. Ye ek ideal situation hai jo har manager should strive to get in the organization, create in the organization. In such organizations, all the employees are motivated and have very few grievances. The second one is high hygiene and low motivation types of organization. So in this situation, the employees have few grievances, but they are not highly motivated. For example of this situation is where pay and working conditions are competitive, theek hai, but the work is not interesting. Interesting nahi lag raha hai, kaam karne ka mani nahi hota, it's a very boring kind of job. So the employees are simply there to collect their salary. Now the third type of organization or team is where there is low hygiene and high motivation. So the employees are highly motivated, but they have a lot of problems, a lot of grievances and complaints. A typical example will be that where the work is exciting and really interesting, but the pay and conditions are behind the competitors in the same industry. So why will your employees be motivated to work harder? They are not getting good pay for their hard work, right? So even though the work is interesting, agar pay kam hai, tab bhi ye ek ideal situation nahi hai. So the fourth type is where low hygiene and low motivation situation prevails. So this is obviously a bad situation for an organization or team, and employees are unmotivated and hygiene factors are not up to scratch. So yep, nobody wants to work, and obviously the organization will ultimately fail. Let's talk about how to use this model. So there are two-step processes to use the two-factor theory model. So step number one is eliminate job hygiene stressors, and step number two is boosting job satisfaction. These are the two important steps. Now let's discuss step number one, that is to eliminate job hygiene stressors. So as we already know, presence of hygiene factors are very important. So to ensure that the hygiene factors are not causing any dissatisfaction, this particular step is important. And each person will examine hygiene factors through their own unique frame of reference. Theek hai? Because of this, it's important to work with each member of your team to understand their specific perspective and also their problems. So hygiene factors sabke liye alag alag concerns ho sakte hai, right? To har kisi ke saath baith kar discuss karna important hai. Now let's look at common steps used by the team or an organization to remove hygiene stresses. So the first one is to rectify petty and bureaucratic company policies, to rectify the policies. Theek hai? Ensure each team members feel supported without feeling micromanaged, right? So ye karne ke liye servant leadership ya democratic leadership style ka use kar sakte hain. To ensure that day-to-day working culture is supportive, koi bullying nahi ho raha hai, there are no cliques, like chote chote, you know, informal groups banke groupism to nahi chal raha hai, ye sare issues to nahi ho rahe, sabko equal respect dena chahiye, ye make sure karna chahiye, theek hai? Ensure that salaries are competitive with the industry, obviously, warna aapke jo achhe employees hai wo aapka team organization chhod ke chale jayenge. Ensure there are no major salary disparities between employees doing similar job. To increase job satisfaction and status, aim to construct jobs in such a way that the team members find the job meaningful. Kisi ko ye na lage ki mera kaam to hai hi nahi kuch, mera koi role hi nahi hai, koi yogdan hi nahi hai organization ki growth mein, aisa nahi hona chahiye. So after removing the hygiene stresses, step number two is to boost job satisfaction. So we can do this by improving the actual job content. Again, a unique approach for each employee will be required to boost job satisfaction in each employee. Now let's look at the methods for boosting job satisfaction. The first one is job enrichment, which means enriching a team member's job by giving them challenging or complex tasks to perform. Isse hoga ki they'll feel motivated, theek hai? And they'll feel important. Unhe lagega ki mujhe challenging kaam diya ja raha because the team believes in me, right? Now the second method is job enlargement. इसका मतलब ये होता है कि आप variety of task बढ़ा देते हैं. मतलब एक आदमी को सिर्फ एक responsibility, एक काम नहीं दिया है, दो तीन और काम दिए. Here you are not increasing the difficulty of the task, but you are increasing the number of tasks given to one person. Now the third method is employee empowerment. Employee empowerment ka matlab hai delegating increasing responsibility to each team member. This can be done by slowly increasing the amount of responsibility delegated to the employee. So slowly, gradually delegating more responsibilities to the employee is employee empowerment method. Now let's look at criticisms of Herzberg's two-factor model. So this theory only applies to white collar jobs. The researchers, they tried to apply this model at the individual level because yahan pe individual ka perception ya situation was not considered under his model. Theek hai? The theory focuses only on improving job satisfaction. That doesn't necessarily translate into increased productivity, right? Also, there is no objective way to measure employee satisfaction within the theory. So this is again one criticism. Two-factor theory is subject to bias. For example, when an employee is satisfied, they will give themselves credit for that satisfaction. Conversely, when they are dissatisfied, they will blame external factors. So biasness definitely prevails because employees, if they are happy with their job, pura credit wo khud ko de denge, theek hai? Aur agar wo khush nahi hai apne kaam se, to बाकी सारे जो एक्सटर्नल फैक्टर्स है, हाइजीन फैक्टर्स है, उनको ब्लेम करेंगे. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग द वीडियो. द नेक्स्ट वीडियो इज गोइंग टू बी ऑन डॉगलस मैकग्रेगर्स थियरी ऑफ मोटिवेशन. सो स्टे ट्यून्ड फॉर दैट. द पीडीएफ ऑफ द लेसन्स विल बी अपलोडेड ऑन द टेलीग्राम चैनल. ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट लिंक्स आर इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स बिलो. एंड प्लीज डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू लाइक, शेयर, कमेंट एंड सब्सक्राइब टू द यूट्यूब चैनल. इट मीन्स द वर्ल्ड टू मी. थैंक यू सो मच. आई विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट वन.